One way or the other, we have all heard of ghost ships. Some of them are in stories, while the rest of them are just hoax stories to scare us. There are even stories of cursed ghost ships that cause misfortune to whoever goes aboard them. However, we do have some real-life ghost ships with spooky backstories. Below are some of the spookiest ghost ships. The SS Bechamo. This was a 230-foot, 1,322-ton cargo steamer built in the Swedish shipyards and owned by the Hudson Bay Company. It was first launched in 1914 to transport goods along the trade route between Sweden and Germany. But after the end of World War I, as part of Germany's war reparations, it was passed over to the UK in 1921. Its new mission was collecting fur pelts and trading them for tobacco, sugar, tea, and weapons along the Canadian coast during the summer seasons. The SS Bechamo circumnavigated the globe for the next decade, carrying supplies between Canada and Scotland. Then on October 31, 1931, while on its way to Vancouver, the ship got trapped in Alaska in an early season ice pack. The ship was coming to the end of a trade run, and the crew needed to wait a couple of days for the ice to break. So they hiked over the ice to the Alaskan town. As luck would have it, a week later, SS Bechamo got trapped in the ice again, but this time more seriously. The Hudson Bay Company airlifted about 20 of its employees out of Dodge. Despite the harsh weather, 14 skilled sailors and the ship's captain decided to stay and look over the ship for the rest of the winter. However, according to Arctic historian Ken Harper, on November 24th, the temperature rose from negative 60 to zero. For 3 days in a row, a blizzard raged, preventing the crew from leaving the shelter they had. When the storm finally stopped and they were able to get out, Bechamo was no longer trapped in the ice. It was not even on the shore. The ship was gone. The crew presumed that their ship sank, but a few days later, an Inuit seal hunter told them he saw it floating some 45 miles away. The crew tracked the ship down, but it was in such bad shape that the captain unloaded any valuable cargo and decided that Bechamo was no longer seaworthy. The abandoned ship remained in the Arctic water, sailing alone without a crew for decades. Its life as a ghost ship began, and it was sighted only 12 times in the following 40 years. The SS Bechamo was last seen floating in the Arctic in 1969. For all we know, she still drifts across the vast waters of the globe. HMS Resolute. The history of the HMS Resolute begins with another ship, the HMS Terror. The name may be familiar to many of you. The Terror joined the HMS Erebus in a mission to find the Northwest Passage in 1845. This body of water was thought to join the Atlantic to the Pacific. Leading the mission was British Sir John Franklin, who took 3 years' worth of provisions for the crew. He also packed a few warm sweaters because the Northwest Passage ran through the Arctic, making it a little chilly. It sounds like a difficult journey for the Royal Navy, and it was. The ice was merciless. Tragically, both crews died. No polar expedition has matched this grim milestone. Before it was known what happened to the HMS Erebus and HMS Terror, another mission was launched to find them. That mission featured no less than 5 vessels commanded by Sir Edward Belcher. One of these ships was the HMS Resolute. The follow-up mission also did not go well for the British Navy. However, this time, Belcher and the crew made it back home, not before 4 out of the 5 ships fell victim to the ice, though, including the Resolute. Belcher's name was tarnished on his return to Great Britain. Meanwhile, the Resolute sat in the ice like a ghost ship until it was discovered by the Americans. A whaling vessel sighted the Resolute, and it took to the States. They set about restoring the craft to its former glory. They repaired it so they could kindly return the ship to England, where it was graciously received by Queen Victoria. By 1879, the HMS Resolute had finally had its day, but a piece of it stayed in America. Octavius. This ghost ship is especially eerie due to what was found on board when discovered in Greenland in the late 18th century. The Octavius had been at sea since 1761 and originally voyaged to the Far East from England as a cargo vessel. The outbound journey sounds like it went pretty well, with the ship reaching its destination after approximately a year on the water. Trouble was, they then had to come back, and for whatever reason, the captain figured it would be a good idea to travel through the icy North Passage. The ship never made it home, and nobody knew what happened to it for years. Fast forward to 1775. A whaling craft named the Herald spotted the Octavius. Upon exploring the ship, the whalers were shocked to find the crew. 25 crewmen and their captain froze to death on board. Frozen at his desk was the captain, with rumors stating he died midway through his work, holding a pen in his hand. Most tragic was the sight of his wife and son, who died in the same quarters. Everyone had died in the icy conditions. Spooked by what they discovered, the crew of the Herald grabbed the ship's logbook and hightailed it out of there. The logbook was frozen solid, and a part of it broke away before being read. The last position in the book placed Octavius roughly 250 miles off Alaska's northernmost point. That was from November 11, 1762, 13 years before the Herald's crew found it. It is theorized that Octavius had become trapped in the ice. At some point, the ice cracked and the ship broke free, continuing its journey successfully through the passage with her frozen crew. Fearing Octavius to be cursed, the Herald left her to drift. The ship was never seen again. Jan Singh. In 2006, Australia's Coast Guard discovered a 260-foot tanker covered with strange paint marks drifting southwest of Queensland in the Gulf of Carpentaria. When authorities found it, no one was on board, and it had a broken tow rope. Nobody knows where it came from or who it belonged to. Any marks that would help identify the vessel had been removed. There were no signs of commotion or illegal activity, such as poaching or smuggling. It just mysteriously showed up. MV Liabuf Orlova. The mighty vessel got into trouble on the high seas while being towed to the Dominican Republic in 2013. The owner was reportedly unable to meet their financial obligations. The ship was on its way to being scrapped for parts at the cost of over $1 million. The sea had other plans for the ship. As water levels rose and the tow rope snapped, the Liabuf Orlova was left drifting on its own, with a story that does not sound very horrific at all. The story gained some traction when it was suggested that there might be an army of rats on board. I Aim 6. In 2003, the Australian Navy discovered a cargo ship called the High Aim 6 in the waters off Exclusive Economic Australia. The 80-foot vessel came from South Taiwan with an Indonesian crew. When authorities went on board, the engine was still chugging, and food and supplies were still in place, but the crew was gone. Everyone on board seems to have seemingly disappeared. Considering the vast distances involved, it is extraordinary that so many people could just disappear. After some investigation, a few crew members were named and even located. They had made it back to Indonesia, but the captain and the engineer of the ship were never found. They did not survive the voyage. Manfred Fritz Bajorat. This ship is less of a ghost ship and more of a ghost. In 2016, a couple of fishermen noticed a ghost ship with a broken mast half-sunk near Mindanao's island in the Philippine Sea. On board was one Manfred Fritz Bajorat, a solitary sailor slumped over a table in the new. His body was very well preserved, like some kind of sea mummy. What happened to Mr. Bajorat? An investigation concluded that the 59-year-old passed away from a heart attack. He was there for approximately 7 days before he was found. Manfred Fritz Bajorat was from Germany and spent much of his life sailing. He did this alone, but used to be accompanied by his wife, who sadly died of cancer in 2010. The Teignmouth Electron. The case of Donald Crowhurst is one of the great ocean-going mysteries. In the late 1960s, he set off to participate in a race around the world in his boat, the Teignmouth Electron. However, he went off-grid for a while, and when the boat was eventually found, there was no sign of Crowhurst. Examining the evidence he left behind, it appears he was out of his depth and attempted to fake details of his advancement during the race. As for the man himself, did he fall overboard? Did he take his own life rather than face people back home? People speculate about the story to this day.